Hey Gemini, what's up? Welcome to your reading. This is going to be for Gemini, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus. Ace of Pentacles in reverse. And we have the Five of Wands. This person's contemplating, you're contemplating on wanting a new start with this person, all right? You want a new beginning with this person, but you're very, very conflicted in your head. There could be a situation where there are too many people involved, or there's just a lot of interference, or this is just you very conflicted, all right? All right, tell me, what does Gemini feel for this person when it comes to a reconciliation? What does Gemini feel for this person when it comes to a reconciliation? Ooh la la, a lot of love. Tell me, what is Gemini's, what action will Gemini take towards this person? What action will Gemini take towards this person? What action will Gemini take towards this person? Six of Pentacles. I like that. I like that. Okay. Now let's talk about the person. Tell me what is going on the person's mind that Gemini is dealing with or that Gemini is in separation with. Page of Pentacles. Okay. What does this person feel for Gemini? Do they want to reconcile? What's in their feelings? Wow, you both have so much love. Knight of Cups. What action will this person take? Eight of Wands. This person really wants to communicate with you. They're desperate. What is going on? What action will this person take towards Gemini when it comes to reconciliation? What action will this person take towards Gemini? Wow, Ace of Cups. I like this. This is an awesome reading. Okay. Tell me, what is the reason? What is going on behind the scenes? Or what is the reason for the situation? What is the root of the issue here? Why is there a separation between Gemini and the person they're dealing with? Justice. Someone wants justice. Someone wants to bring balance to the situation. Someone needs to make a logical decision. There could be someone out here, okay, who felt very imbalanced in the situation. This person felt things weren't fair. Whatever, okay? This side, Gemini, you seem to be the more matured one out here rather than this one, okay? That's just how I feel. All right, tell me, what is the mutual energy? What's the mutual energy between Gemini and the person they're dealing with? What's the mutual energy during this time of separation? I love these cards to the core. They're so pretty, and especially in the black mat, it looks even more prettier. Wow, you both want to move forward like quick speed, you know? You both either want to travel towards each other, but you're both are very, very determined to move forward, okay? You both want to get this relationship moving really quick. The Chariot is the energy of where if you want success, okay, if you want something to go your way or if you want success, right? There are only two things which drive the Chariot to move towards something that they're wanting or something that they're wishing and willing on, and that is determination and the willingness. All right, so this is definitely wanting forward moment, okay? But this is you both determined to take control of the situation. Tell me, is there a chance of reconciliation between Gemini and the person they're dealing with this week? What are the chances of a reconciliation between Gemini and the person they're dealing with this week? What are the chances of reconciliation between Gemini and the person they're dealing with this week? One card. Give me one card. Three of Pentacles. Okay, with the Queen of Pentacles at the bottom of the deck. I like that. Okay, let's see. I don't like to open my mouth till I don't clarify the cards because clarifications can change the entire message, okay? Let's clarify. Overall, both of y'all are in love. You both love each other. It's just that Gemini, you're someone who just doesn't know if you can get things off ground with this person. Probably you invested into this person in the past, okay, and things didn't go your way or something was a bad investment, all right? But when it comes to loving this person, you love them a lot, okay? You're just someone who's not the best at expressing your emotions. This person, on the other hand, they have a lot of love for you, okay? And they're wanting to open up, come towards you, express themselves emotionally, wanting to be vulnerable towards you. In their mind, they're definitely choosing or wanting to make some kind of initiation towards you. They want to take action. And with the Page of Pentacles, it looks like they definitely want to offer something committed to you, okay? There is communication coming in from this side, okay? This week. Six of Pentacles is the action that you want to take, okay? So you want, this is not an action card. This is more like what you want. So to me, with the Six of Pentacles, it feels like you are definitely wanting a very, very balanced relationship out here, okay? So it looks like you have put in all your work and effort into this in the past, okay? But something made you feel very imbalanced, okay? Because something was very one-sided. You either felt like you were taken advantage of, or you just were getting the bare minimum, okay? So your attitude is like either I get a balanced, equal give and take kind of relationship, or I don't want it at all, okay? That's why in your mind here you're just feeling if something, this is that self-doubt of if you can make things happen with this person or not, okay? If there is something long term with this person, it's literally like, you know, you want, you're trying to think if something can work out, but it's something that doesn't make sense to you long term, okay? You just don't know if you can have something long term with this person. This person out here definitely has thought about it, okay? They have the opportunity that is there and they're coming in to work on it. That's a very diligent lover. That's someone who wants to put in the hard work, okay? Definitely someone who's planning and manifesting something to make things right with you. They're planning communication, okay? But it's just that they take their time, okay? And this is someone who just doesn't give their energy to anybody, all right? They're constantly trying to think about how to make things work out, okay? In a way that it makes sense long term. All right, let's clarify. Tell me about the Ace of Pentacles in reverse. Why is the Ace of Pentacles in reverse here on Gemini's mind? They're coming in, Gemini. Let's see. Eight of Pentacles in reverse. So it definitely looks to me like with the Eight of Pentacles in reverse here, you feel that you... So I'm getting, like I said, right? You have put in a lot of hard work. All right, for sure. I'm sorry, is my hand coming in between? I'm just trying to check my hand. You've been putting a lot of hard work. Yeah. So we have the Eight of Pentacles in reverse, the Ace of Wands and the Magician here. So basically, you put in a lot of hard work, like I said, right? You have been very patient with this person, okay? And wanting things to progress. But somewhere, somehow, you feel you're lacking the motivation to invest anything more into this person, okay? Because you feel your efforts are not being valued. With the Magician here, you do have a lot of... you have that willingness to make things happen with this person out here, okay? Because the Magician here is someone who doesn't doubt themselves, okay? So yeah, you have a lot of confidence in yourself that you can make things happen or something can go in your favor. And with the Ace of Wands here, all right? You're realizing your true power. You want to manifest this person, all right? And with the Ace of Wands here, you definitely want a brand new beginning with this person. You are very passionate about them. But with the Star in reverse here, you're losing hope and faith if things can happen, okay? If things can work out. Because I'm constantly getting Gemini, you've done a lot in this relationship here, okay? Whilst it was a very unbalanced situation, okay? All right, tell me about the Page of Pentacles on this person's mind. Where's the Page of Pentacles here on this person's mind, please? Knight of Swords, they are in a hurry. This person's in a hurry to communicate with me, communicate with you, okay? This person feels the need to talk to you right now. We have the Five of Pentacles in reverse and the Strength here. This person is going to do everything under the sun that they can, okay? To tame the situation, okay, with the Strength here. So what I'm feeling here is with the Ace of Pentacles in reverse, you both have Ace of Pentacles in reverse here, okay? Which looks to me that you both want this, but you both are doubting if this is going to work out long term. Yeah, that's what I'm getting. You both feel that something's either a missed opportunity, or you both feel that, you know, something isn't realistic long term. At least you feel like that, okay, because you put in your work. This person feels like that, probably, and that's why they're hurrying up. Maybe they feel it's a missed opportunity if they don't make that effort towards you, okay? That's why with the Page of Pentacles and the Knight of Swords, not only are they taking action, but they're going to communicate this with you, okay? But with the Strength here, I feel that they're going to do whatever it takes to make things work out, you know? I don't see this person holding back. The Strength is holding back, but I feel this is someone who's going to try and tame the situation, okay? They're going to do what it takes to make things happen with you. There is this doubt there that they have, but they're still going to make... They're going to make that effort. Tell me about the King of Cups here. Why is this in Gemini's feelings? What is Gemini's King of Cups? Why is this King of Cups in Gemini's feelings? One more card, please. Wow. So, Gemini. With the King of Cups, we have the Two of Cups in reverse. And we have the... We have the Ten of Cups here. This is what you feel, okay? You have a lot of love for this person. You probably even want commitment with this person, okay? But right now, with the Two of Cups in reverse here, I feel like you guys, you're not on the same page with this person. okay, you guys are not seeing eye to eye, but you're making a very heart over head decision, okay, and you're choosing to hold back. Again, there is love here, okay, but you're choosing to hold back here with the Three of Wands, or you're waiting for this person to come towards you. There is a lot of manifestation going on your side, Gemini. But yeah, you see this person as your happily ever after, but you know what I'm getting? Three of Wands is the card of manifestation, right? So I feel that you're not putting in your work this time because you've done enough, right? But you're manifesting this person, and right now you're choosing to be content wherever you are. Take it either ways. Either you want commitment with this person, but you're just choosing to stay content where you are, because right now you guys are just not together, okay? There's an imbalance out here. But again, you do have a lot of love here with the King of Cups here, but you're choosing, you're not the best at expressing them, okay? So you're just going to keep quiet and love them from a distance. What is the Knight of Cups here in this person's feelings? Why does this person feel the Knight of Cups? Queen of Swords in reverse here. They're so scared of you. They see you as someone very, very negative right now. Very negative, okay? You're being hypercritical right now, Gemini. They're very intimidated by you. They don't know if you're going to give them a second chance here. The Queen of Swords in reverse, okay? So now, she is someone, you know, so you know what? It's literally like, this is someone who's either negative or they're just feeling like this towards you, okay? They're very pissed off with you. They're very angry with you. I feel like they're angry because they don't know what to do with so much love that they have for you. They have so much love for you, and it's like, I hate it that I love you. It's almost like that song, you know, it's a Bollywood song. It says, I hate you that I love you. I hate it that I love you, something like that, right? That's the kind of energy I'm getting from this person here. See, Four of Cups, this person is fearing rejection. That's why the Ace of Pentacles is over. This person's fearing rejection. That could be one of the reasons why they're holding back here. Because with the Seven of Cups, this person does not know which is the right approach to make towards you. Like, what can I just do that my Gemini would just say a yes to me, you know? Or they would just take me back. Seriously, that's what I'm getting. This person has a lot of a fear of rejection. They don't want you to just cut them off completely, okay? And they're also pissed off with themselves because they have so much love for you. But there's this lack of expression. They don't know what can they say in order to put forth their point in a very logical way, or in a way that you can understand. They're very discontented without you. They're not happy without you. Tell me about the Six of Pentacles. Tell me about the Six of Pentacles. Why is the Six of Pentacles in Gemini's? Six of Pentacles. Clarified by the Six of Pentacles in reverse here, with the Sun in reverse here. Give me one more card for the Six of Pentacles. Tell me, why is the Six of Pentacles here? Give me one more card for the Six of Pentacles. I knew it. All right, we'll take it. Nine of Swords in reverse and the Seven of Swords. I feel, Gemini, you're very focused on balancing the situation, okay? Because there was a very huge imbalance between you and this person, okay? Something was one-sided here, and now you're choosing yourself, Gemini, okay? Like I said, you're very content where you are. There has been a breakup separation. Yes, agreed, you have a lot of love for this person. But when it comes to your approach towards this person, it's like, no, do I really want to do this again? You're trying to see the light at the end of the tunnel, okay? But I also feel that you're no longer making this person a priority in your life. You've done stressing. You're done stressing. You're done being in that panic mode, okay? You could be overthinking and overanalyzing, but you're not doing that anymore. And I think with the Seven of Swords, you're trying to get away from this person, okay? That's why this person probably almost feels it's a missed opportunity. And if they don't do anything about it, you're going to be the one who got away. And that's what you're doing. You're trying to get away from this person. I feel that you feel this person coming in towards you, okay? And you're just like trying to make up some shit in a way where you can just escape this person. I don't think you want to... Again, it's just because you have love for someone does not mean that you still want to be with this person, okay? Because this person could be keeping you in cycles, you know, dragging this connection, whatever. Tell me about the Ace of Cups. What is the Ace of Cups here? Why is the Ace of Cups here? The World. Give me one more card for the Ace of Cups. One more card for the Ace of Cups. Page of Wands, yeah, this person's coming in, okay? with the Page of Wands, the Ace of Cups, and the World here. So this person definitely wants to start a new cycle with you, for sure, okay? They have a lot of love for you. This time they're ready to open up emotionally. If this was someone who's holding back from you, they're ready to open up, express themselves, okay? They're ready to be vulnerable. They're coming in with that communication, okay? And with the World here, they want to move things to the next level with you, for sure. They want to take things to the next level. So if you guys were friends, they want to date you. If you guys were dating, they want to get into something exclusive. If you were exclusive and you broke up, they want to get into a commitment, okay? But this is someone who's definitely, you know, releasing and surrendering, and they want something new with you. This is taking things to the next level here. Why is the Justice here? Tell me, why is this the reason for the separation or breakup? Why is the Justice here? See, it's all about balance. It's about, I'm feeling something was not fair, you know. Gemini, you could have felt things weren't fair. And that's why you could have ended things with this person. There is a lot of love here because we have the Two of Cups here. But probably when it came to something, some kind of label, or you could have been with this person for a very long time. And when you asked for something, you know, that you really wanted to make things happen. And that's when they, yeah. You were bored of this situation, you know, repeating itself over and over again. Yeah, see, you thought this was fucking toxic. Knight of Pentacles, Three of Pentacles in reverse, and the Justice here. All right, so this is what happened. You have cut off this person, Gemini, is what I'm getting, because you tried to maintain a balance here, okay? Something felt, you wanted to balance things up because you were feeling very imbalanced with this person. You finally used your logic. You were practical and very rational about what you did, and you cut this person off, okay? Because you were hitting a wall with this person, okay? Every single time you wanted to talk to this person, they refused to work with you. They refused to put in their work, their effort, okay? They just refused to make something happen or build on a very concrete foundation with you. Of course, with the Devil here, this was something which was very, very toxic, okay? And you probably realized that over time, that this was a pattern that was repeating itself over and over again. This was more like an addiction, okay? More like a codependency. You felt restricted, okay? That you couldn't get rid of this connection. And finally, probably with the Knight of Pentacles in reverse here, I'm feeling that you let go of this connection because there was just no movement, okay? I'm picking up, you could be dealing with someone who never made this relationship a priority, okay? And that's why you had to leave, okay? Because this was either someone who was lacking the effort or, you know, into the situation. Anyways, you could be dealing with someone who was very slow moving towards you, okay? They would take step by step, baby steps towards you. You never knew if you were a priority. Their business, their career, their money, their goals, everything was a priority but you, okay? And this was someone who was dragging a situation, okay? That's what I was picking up. And that's why you finally, you brought balance to yourself is what I'm getting by letting this relationship go. What's the Chariot here? Tell me about the Chariot, please. Why is the Chariot here? Two of Pentacles, contemplation. Tell me about the Chariot here, please. Chariot with the Chariot and the Tower here. Wow. There's going to be this sudden movement, you know, with the Tower here. Something's going to change all of a sudden. That's the mutual energy. You both want this, okay? I feel you both want to move towards each other, okay? To balance out the situation. Or I'm feeling you both want this so bad because we have the Chariot card twice. Whenever there's a card twice, the energy is double up. So which means that if you want to make something a success, if you both want to make things work out, it's going to need that action, okay? That decisive action, that willingness, determination, okay? To make something move forward here, okay? Distance could be a big issue between you guys. But with the Tower and Two of Pentacles here, I'm getting something has to drastically change. There is something that needs to be changed, okay? But with the Two of Pentacles here, in order to balance this situation, you're both going to have to make a decision, okay? Because I feel there's a lot of contemplation going on, okay? What to do, what to do, what to do. Probably more from this person, okay? Because you're very sure about what you want in your approach, okay? You're very sure. This person is someone who's wanting to make things right, okay? But they're still contemplating. Should they not? At least the good part is that they are willing and determined to make things happen with you, okay? About the Tower here, it's like an epiphany, okay? It's like a new realization that this person has here. But there's that indecision, okay? Like they say, right? Consciously, you want to do something, but subconsciously, they're indecisive, okay? That's why things are not moving forward. Your vibrations, your desires don't make a reality, vibrations make a reality. Okay, so yes, this person desires you, they want to make things right, that's their desire, but that's not going to become a reality because they're not vibrating at the same level, if you get what I'm saying. The Chariot is their desire. Okay, I want to move forward, I want to go to my Gemini, I want to make things happen, I want another chance. But with the Two of Pentacles, that's their vibration and their subconscious, okay, which is constantly making them feel like, should I not, weighing out the pros and cons. Okay, so that's what I'm just saying. Tell me about the Three of Pentacles here. What's the Three of Pentacles? What is this Three of Pentacles? Definitely looks like someone's wanting to come in and work towards you and build on you, build with you. Okay, towards a partnership. They want to work towards a partnership. Someone very serious. Okay, ready to be on the same page with you. Too many cards, babe. Too many cards. Okay. Nine of Cups here. This is a wish fulfillment, okay, but this is also some you who makes this person very, very happy. So with the Three of Pentacles, the Fool in reverse, and the Queen of Wands in reverse, the Queen of Wands in reverse has come out before also at the bottom of the deck. I feel this person wants to work with you, okay, for sure, but again, there is this risk factor, okay, that this person keeps contemplating. I feel, to me, it feels like as the outcome here, this person is going to come in towards you, okay, but you're going to be the one who's going to be contemplating on whether you still want to give this person another chance. And literally, I'm getting, do I really want to be another fool and take a leap of faith and move towards this person? Because you've been through hell and back with this person, all right, you have. And I feel with the Queen of Wands in reverse here, you just don't, this person makes you feel very insecure. Okay, you're lacking the confidence, okay, of whether this can happen with this person or not, okay? You're absolutely lacking the confidence. You're not confident enough of whether you want to take action towards this person. That's what's happening. So I feel if you're talking about reconciliation, definitely Three of Pentacles, they are coming to work things out with you. Gemini, it's you who I am very doubtful of whether you want to make things happen with this person or not. Okay? Because with the Nine of Cups here, two ways. Either you are very happy and content where you are, okay? Or this is something that's going to make you very happy, okay, when they come in. But taking a risk, I don't think you want to do that. Because again, I'm telling you, this person, you constantly doubt yourself with this person, you know? So yeah, that's what I have for you, Gemini. I hope this reading resonates with you. Leave your comments below. Like, share, subscribe, and I will see you next time. Bye-bye.